Some units we interact with actually have two units built into them, such as miles per hour. When we do these conversions with dual units, we're going to remember that we know per is the fraction bar. So we'll have miles per hour, it'll be miles over hour. And then when we make our conversions, we will convert one unit at a time. For example, if I've got 45 ounces per minute, and I want to convert that to some number of pounds per hour, we can follow the exact same process we've seen in our previous videos, where per is the fraction bar. So we've got 45 ounces, per is the fraction bar, so the minute goes on the bottom. That's what we're starting with. Then we'll convert one unit at a time. For example, we don't want those ounces. We're going to convert those ounces, looking at my final result. On top, we want pounds. So to get rid of the ounces, we'll put them on the bottom. And we can convert ounces into pounds. And looking at my conversion sheet, I see that in 1 pound, there are 16 ounces. The ounces now divide out, and I'm left with the pounds that I'm looking for. But that just fixes the numerator. In the denominator, we have minutes, and we want hours in the denominator. So we'll set up another conversion factor. To get rid of minutes, because they're on the bottom, I'm going to put the minutes on top. And I can convert minutes to hours, because I know 60 minutes is 1 hour. That way, the minutes divide out on top and bottom, and I'm left with the hours that I'm looking for. And now that I have the two units that I'm looking for, I'm ready to multiply across the top. 40 times 1 times 60 is going to give me 2,700 pounds. On the bottom, I have 16 times 1 is 16 hours. And 2,700 divided by 16 is 168.75 pounds per hour. Let's try another example where we have to convert multiple units. Let's say I'm going 35 miles per hour. And I want to convert that to the number of feet per second that I travel. Well, we start off with per being the fraction bar. So we've got 35 miles per hour. The hour is going on the bottom. I want to change to feet per second. We want feet on top and seconds on the bottom. So we don't want the miles on top. To get rid of them, I'll put the miles on the bottom. And what I can convert miles into is feet. I can look up that there are 5,280 feet in 1 mile, and the miles divide out. Now we've got those feet on top like we want, but we still need to make the denominator work out. We don't want hours in the bottom. So to get rid of them, we'll put the hours on top. I can change hours into minutes pretty quickly, because in 1 hour, I know there are 60 minutes. The hours now divide out, but we don't want minutes. So we just use another conversion factor. The minutes are in the denominator. We don't want them. I'll put them on top. We can change minutes into second, because in 1 minute, there are 60 seconds. Using the units to tell me where to put the numbers, putting units in opposite places to divide them out, minutes cross off with minutes, leaving behind the seconds that I'm looking for. Now I'm ready to multiply across the top. We've got the 35 times the 5,280 times 1 times 1 is 184,800 feet on top. Over 60 times 60 is 3,600 seconds. And when we divide by 3,600, we get 51.33, approximately, feet per second is the same as 35 miles per hour. It's your turn to practice some of these conversions. Remember, even if you know a different way to do these conversions, we need you to learn this method, because we're really setting you up for what you're going to see in your science classes. Knowing this method will give you an advantage in your science classes. So take the time to learn this method, show your work, practice doing these, and let your instructor know if you have any questions.